Now we are going to learn about converse of Pythagoras theorem. The statement of this theorem is, in a triangle, the square of one side of a triangle is equal to sum of squares of remaining two sides, then the triangle is right angled triangle. So here triangle ABC is given, in which square of one side is equal to sum of squares of remaining two sides is given. That means in triangle ABC, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. This is given. That means in we have to prove that this triangle is a right angle triangle. Means we have to prove that angle ABC is 90 degree. So if we prove that angle ABC is 90 degree, that means the triangle will be a right angle triangle. Now construction. Here we have to draw another triangle, triangle PQR, such that segment AB and segment PQ are congruent, and segment BC, segment QR are congruent. At the same time, angle PQR is a right angle. Now, in proof, in triangle ABC, it is given that AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Now, in triangle PQR, triangle PQR is a right angle triangle. Means we can use Pythagoras theorem for this triangle PQR. So by using Pythagoras theorem, we can write PR square is equal to PQ square plus QR square. PQ is congruent with segment AB, therefore PQ square can be replaced by AB square, and segment QR is congruent to segment BC, so QR square can be replaced by BC square. So AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. So here we can replace AB square plus BC square by AC square. So PR square is equal to AC square. Taking square root on both sides, we get PR is equal to AC. If properly we can write it, segment PR congruent segment AC. Let it be equation number 2, because we have to use this step in the next part. So in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, segment AB is congruent with segment PQ. Segment BC is congruent with segment QR. These are the construction steps. And segment AC congruent segment PR, that we have written from equation 2, because already it is proved. So triangle ABC congruent triangle PQR by yes test of congruence. Now from this we can take the corresponding elements that we want, that is angle ABC congruent angle PQR corresponding angle of congruent triangle. Now if the angles are congruent, that means their measures are equal, therefore measure of angle ABC is equal to measure of angle PQR. But measure of angle PQR is 90 degree, therefore measure of angle ABC will be 90 degree. In this way we got that triangle ABC is a right angle triangle. So lastly here we can write triangle ABC is a right angle triangle. We are going to learn about application of Pythagoras theorem. In this, three different proofs are there. First is regarding acute angle triangle. That means one angle we have taken as acute angle. So here in this figure we have taken angle B as acute angle. So here we have written measure of angle B is less than 90. Then segment AD is perpendicular to BC. So segment AD is perpendicular to BC. Now in this case we have to prove AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square minus 2BC multiplied by BD. So for that the next step is proof. AC square, that means we want AC square, that means we have to take this right angled triangle. So in triangle ADC angle D is equal to 90 degree, therefore by Pythagoras theorem AC square is equal to AD square plus BC square. Let it be step number 1. Now in the same way here we are having another right angled triangle, that is triangle ADB. So similarly in triangle ADB angle D is equal to 90 degree, therefore AB square is equal to AD square plus BD square. Step number 2. In both the cases we are having AD square here. So if we arrange equation 2, so arranging equation 2, we get AD square is equal to AB square minus BD square. Let it be step number 3. Now this value of AD square we have to place in equation 1. So here we can write from 1 and 3. AC square is equal to AB square minus BD square plus DC square. Now here AC square we got on right hand side, we got AB square. Now we want BC square. So for that here we have to make the substitution. So AB square minus BD square plus DC. DC we can write as BC minus BD. So BC minus BD bracket square. So is equal to AB square minus BD square plus BC square A square minus 2AB, that is 2BC multiplied by BD plus BD square. So AB square minus BD square plus BC square minus 2BC multiplied by BD plus BD square. So this BD square and minus BD square will get cancelled. So it becomes AB square plus BC square minus 2BC multiplied by BD. So AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square minus 2BC multiplied by BD. So in this way we can prove this property. Now the another proof is proof regarding obtuse angle triangle. So here the figure is triangle ABC is an obtuse angle triangle. AD is perpendicular drawn on side BC in this way. So obtuse angle is mentioned, as well as AD is perpendicular to BC is also mentioned in the given part. Now to prove AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square plus 2BC into BD. So this we have to prove. So first of all here two right angle triangles are there. One is ADB and another one is ADC. So first of all we are going to take triangle ADC. So in triangle ADC, angle ADC is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, AC square is equal to AD square plus DC square. Step number 1. Similarly, in triangle ADB, angle ADB is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, AB square is equal to AD square plus DB square. Step number 2. We have to arrange this equation 2. So, arranging equation 2, we get AD square is equal to AB square minus DB square. Let it be step number 3. Now, in place of AD square in equation 1, we have to place equation 3. So it becomes from 1 and 3, AC square is equal to AB square minus DB square plus DC square plus DC square. So here in place of DC, we can write DB plus BC. So AB square minus DB square plus DB plus BC bracket square. So AB square minus DB square plus, we have to expand this using A plus B bracket square formula. So DB square plus BC square plus 2BD into BC. So BD square and this BD square will get cancelled. So it becomes AB square plus BC square plus 2BD multiplied by BC. So AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square plus 2BD into BC. In this way, we can use this proof. Now we are going to learn about Apollonius theorem. In this, Apollonius theorem is application of Pythagoras theorem. That means in the figure, right angle triangles must be there. So here AD is perpendicular to BC, forms different right angle triangles. And Apollonius theorem is applicable for medians. So here AE is median. So in given part we can write, in triangle ABC, segment AD perpendicular segment BC. Segment AE is median. Now to prove, AB square plus AC square is equal to 2AE square plus 2BE square. This we have to prove. Next step is proof. Here in this proof, we have to use the previous two proofs, that is proof regarding acute angle triangle and obtuse angle triangle. Both the proofs here we have to use here. Now, first of all, AB square, for that we have to use this angle E. So in triangle ABE, measure of angle AEB is less than 90 degree. Therefore, we can write AB square is equal to AB square is equal to AE square plus BE square minus 2BE into DE. Let it be step number 1. In the same way, for obtuse angle triangle, we have to use this angle E. So, in triangle AEC, measure of angle AEC is greater than 90 degree. Therefore, we can write AC square is equal to AE square plus EC square plus 2EC multiplied by ED. Step number 2. Now we have to add these two equations, because the to prove step contains left hand side AB square plus AC square. So if we add these two equations, we get AB square plus AC square. So adding 1 and 2, AB square plus AC square is equal to AB square plus BE square minus 2BE multiplied by DE plus AE square plus EC square plus 2EC multiplied by DE. Now next step, AB square plus BE square. BE and EC are one and the same, so here we can write AB square plus BE square minus 2BE into DE plus AE square plus, here EC is there, EC is equal to BE, so we can replace it by BE square plus 2BE into DE. This we have written with the reference BE is equal to EC. Now next step, AE plus AE, 2AE, BE plus BE, 2BE. AE square plus AE square, 2BE square, BE square plus BE square, 2BE square, and this will get cancelled. So we get AB square plus AC square is equal to 2AE square plus 2BE square. In this way, we can prove Apollonius theorem. So this is the first example from exercise 2.2. Here we have to find out length of segment QR. So solution: in triangle PQR, segment PS is median. When median is given, that time we can use Apollonius theorem. So by Apollonius theorem, we can write PQ square plus PR square is equal to 2PS square plus 2QS square. PQ is 11, 11 square plus 17 square is equal to 2 multiplied by PS square plus 2QS square. 11 square is 121 plus this is 289 is equal to 2 2 multiplied by 169 plus 2 qs square. So 9 plus 1, 10, carry 1. 9 plus 2, 11, carry 1. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 1, 4. 410 is equal to 2 multiplied by 169. 2 9s are 18, carry 1. 2 6 are 12 plus 1, 13, carry 1, 2 into 1, 2 plus 1, 3. So plus 2 qs square. So 2 qs square is equal to 410 minus 338. So 10 minus 8, 2, carry 1. 11 minus 4, 7. Carry 1, 4 minus 4, 0. So 72 is equal to 2 qs square. So 72 upon 2 is equal to qs square. 36 is equal to qs square. So 6 is equal to qs. Qs is equal to 6. Now we want qr. So qr is equal to 2 multiplied by qs. So 2 multiplied by 6, that is 12. Qr is equal to 12. Now we will take another example, that is example number 5 of exercise 2.2. Now in this example, quadrilateral PQRS is a rectangle. Point T is in the interior of rectangle at this position. Now we have to prove TS square plus TQ square is equal to TP square plus TR square. The construction step is draw segment AB parallel to segment SR, and this segment AB is passing through point T. So A dash T dash B, in this way it is there. Now we have to prove this step. So for that, first of all we will write segment AB parallel segment SR and segment SR parallel segment PQ. Therefore we can write segment PQ parallel segment SR parallel segment AB. That means all these three lines are parallel lines. Now here all the angles of rectangle are right angles. That means here the angles formed at A and at B will also become right angles. Therefore here we can write quadrilateral PABQ and quadrilateral ASRB are rectangles. Means here in that case we can write PA is equal to BQ and AS is equal to BR. Let it be step number 1, and the reference we can write opposite sides of rectangle. Now in triangle TAP, angle TAP is equal to 90 degree, therefore we can write TP square is equal to TA square plus PA square. Let it be step number 2 by using Pythagoras theorem. So here we can write the reference Pythagoras theorem. Similarly in triangle TAS, angle TAS is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, TS square is equal to TA square plus AS square. Step number 3. In triangle TBQ, angle TBQ is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, TQ square is equal to TB square plus BQ square. Step number 4. And in triangle TBR, angle TBR is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, TR square is equal to TB square plus BR square. Let it be step number 5. Now, this is the preparation before starting this proof. Now, here we want TS square plus TQ square. So, TS square is equation number 3 and TQ square is equation number 4. So, adding equation 3 and 4, next step is adding equation 3 and 4. So, TS square plus TQ square is equal to TA square plus AS square plus TB square plus BQ square. Next, TA square plus AS square. AS can be replaced by BR. TA square and AS can be replaced by BR. So here we can write BR square plus TB square plus BQ can be replaced by PA. So PA square. This changes we did by using equation 1. So here we can write from equation 1. Now again we will arrange it properly. So TA square plus TA square plus PA square plus TB square plus BR square. Only we arranged all the terms properly. TA square plus PA square first and TB square plus BR square in the second. Now, TA square plus PA square is nothing but TB square plus TB square plus BR square is TR square. So, TR square and the left hand side is TS square plus TQ square is equal to TP square plus TR square, and the same step that we want in this